Hi, and welcome back. I'm going to moderate the conversation between Carmen Jose and, or Jose, right?
Yeah,
I'm saying it correctly. And Camille Verschuren. Welcome. They are from Growing Space, which is a cultural and social place in the Wielewaal. It's for the neighbors and artists to come together, especially in the corona times. The exhibitions are every week, and they are in a greenhouse where people can safely, from a distance and from outside, see the exhibitions. Camille, would you like to introduce yourself and who you are?
Yes, I'm an artist living and working in Rotterdam since 1987. I think so, a long time already. But I mainly work in public space, but also in the last few years, very much busy with self-organization and part of several foundations. One is Foundation BAD, BAD, which is in the south, where I live and work since 1991. And so have been busy in the south of Rotterdam ever since. And and part in this project, mainly through a foundation NAC, which is a self-management organization that since 2004 tries to manage all the empty housing in the district of Charloes, or the former district of Charloes. And through that, many artists found a place to live and to work. And so from this kind of greater collective of artistic people, I'm involved in the Growing Space.
Cool. Yeah, it's really nice. And Carmen, could you do the same, introduce yourself?
Sure. So I'm an artist and an educator, and I'm now 2.5 years in Rotterdam. I landed in Rotterdam in BAD Foundation. That's where I also met Camille. In the guest studio for half a year, and then thank you to Camille, I had the opportunity to be another half a year in one of the NAC houses in the Wielewaal for another residency time, and then after that I had another house, and then I was back to the Wielewaal now, where I live since a year now, also thanks to Camille. So far in Rotterdam, I'm active as a facilitator in art education, but also as an artist. And I have my studio in Slinge, so I'm also pretty based in the south. Sometimes not coming out at all. And in the Wielewaal now, yeah.
Yeah, okay, that's cool. I said it very short what Growing Space is. Maybe you guys can add in something about it.
Well, actually, it begins with a question of Carmen, so maybe Carmen should start at the beginning of it.
Yeah, like how did you come up or start? Did you initiate it, the Growing Space?
We initiated together.
Together.
But it came from a question because I had the privilege to have one of the ONO grants at CBK. Mm-hmm. I got last year, so I was 4 to 5 years researching with this grant. And then on one of the last periods of getting like one of the parts of the money, I asked what was going to happen at the beginning of the pandemic with the traveling grants money, and if there was any options to propose projects to redistribute this money, especially because we were quite worried about the artists that have non-European backgrounds. Yeah. And if they were going to get TOSO, and if not, if it was going to jeopardize their status of the visa, and so on. And in this conversation with CBK and Camille, we started having a longer conversation and starting to think, well, what should we do? And also especially in the south, in the Wielewaal, if there was an option to start in a space, or like to open up a space where shows could continue in a time where most cultural centers and spaces were closed, and how to redistribute that money to the people that, and to the artists, which is our closer community, that were most vulnerable in that time.
Yeah, it's a super nice initiative. It's a hard time for all of us with the dozo and everything. So it's a good thing. Do you have anything to add in?
Maybe it's important to say that. So this question came from Carmen. So and also the appeal. So like how do we take care of each other, and especially the ones that cannot access the normal regulations or. And so that actually happened before any formal regulation was made through the CBK or any other funding institute, and also had to be fast. So okay, if you make a plan and you can think about it for a long time, but then you know time is running out somehow. We managed to kind of through the project Growing Space. So you cannot distribute the money directly. There has to be a project, and there has to be a kind of visual aspect of it, or a kind of public aspect of it as well. So the Growing Space then became a format to show work without having the need for an audience, because it's in public space, it's outdoors, people can walk around, can pass it every day. But also you had the issue of how many people do you want to help, or how many people can you help? Mm-hmm. So it has to be fast. And a lot, as much as possible. So we had, the kind of ambitious idea to make 24 exhibitions in half a year, every week, every week a different one, and which was a good idea, and is a good idea, because therefore many people had access to the funding we kind of generated. But at the same time, also a lot of work every week, building up, building down.
I can imagine.
Yeah, and I would like also to add that this was also like thanks to the collaboration also with NAC, and also thanks to the structure that NAC already has built for a while. So like there's a net of artists, there's a net of support, and also like a background that because this project is based on the thanks on the funding of CBK, but also Charles Special and also NAC. So like without these three legs, it wouldn't be possible. And also like that's also
A big thank you.
Yeah, and also part of this collaboration, no? Like coming together with these questions and these ideas and this energy also to make something happen.
Yeah. Oh, that's beautiful. I do have a question about you have this project and you're starting up and it's taking shape. How did you come up with the idea to put it into a greenhouse? How did it get his shape?
I think it was Carmen, I think, no?
Yeah, well, the Bilbao is quite like a special neighborhood. It's these small houses, and there's a lot of green space. And well, living there, I noticed that there was a lot of people that in this time of like lockdown or like half lockdown were walking around and getting some air. So there was the idea of, okay, well, it would be nice to have like a small showcase space. And so this idea was, okay, how can we, as a transparent cube or something, and this was all the ideas that I started maturating, but also like in conversation with Camille, it's like, okay, what could we do? And then together we thought, oh, maybe container, maybe another structure. Mm-hmm. And we went through a lot of ideas, and then we came to this idea of the greenhouse, because it's a space that is transparent, so it's really COVID safe. So like the artists are the only ones who access the inside, and the public is only from the outside, and also through this platform, which maybe Camille can talk a bit about it.
Mm-hmm. Yes, please.
Yeah, I can like keep the distance, but also see who is in the space.
Yeah.
Yeah, so we thought about, because the difficulty is in that area is not only that there is, the difficulty is that it's being regenerated. So more than one third of the existing house is already demolished into a brownfield site. And so we had to find a location also where there would not be any activity during the coming 3 years or 2 years or 1 year. So we found a place where that didn't happen, or supposed not to be happening, hopefully. But also then what happens with, I mean, visually, but also maybe conceptually, if you put a greenhouse in the grass, just that would then be in reality somehow and would be vulnerable to all kind of activities around it, visually and also in terms of how you look at the thing. So then the idea came up to elevate the greenhouse on a platform. and connect that platform with the four paths that kind of bring it into a spatial relationship with the surroundings, but at the same time take it away from the direct surroundings and give it a kind of or possible abstract place. So not all work, some work works better when it has a kind of separate spatial condition, and other works work better in direct reality, but to give both options, to lift it up a bit and give it its own kind of space within the space, and also have four access paths, so you can see who's coming, and it's kind of clear where you are and not are. So, I mean, in summertime, it was also possible to sit on the platforms and on distance, but still be gathering outside with the regulated distance, and made it into kind of like a hangout place.
Also, like, important to add to that is that the Billabong also doesn't has another, so it's like quite divided because of this redevelopment process. So it's like the community of the neighbors, but also like the redevelopment community, or like the part of the newcomers community. And like for me and for Camille and for some other people, there was like a need of some outside space where people could get together and like some sense of like, yeah, coming together to talk and kind of a building bridges in between of a very divided through the process neighborhood. And yeah, this came also from that idea, and also from the idea of like many artists live there in the Knack houses, but also like there's this very old community that lived there already for 60 years and they were born there. Yeah, so like trying to bring all these
To connect them.
Yeah
That's super nice. So there are a lot of nice aspects about Willewaal, and I'm very curious about your personal connection with the neighborhood and Willewaal itself. I don't know if you have any experiences or stories you like to share about the neighborhood Willewaal.
I would like to share that it's very interesting. It has been very interesting for me how the lockdown and all this process of the pandemic has brought me way, way closer to the neighbors. Like, and I met so many new neighbors, and I'm now part of like the Christmas Commission, which is we're getting like
that's
the
nice.
Full Billabong full of lights. Also because it's quite a challenging time, and how do you come together when you cannot be in the same room and you cannot be in the same way? So like there's other ways, or like you're trying to find other ways, and mostly it's like through the being outside. So for me, community gardens, but also these lights, or like Christmas decorations, but also these events that happened before in the growing space till the events were cancelled. But it still has been like always space for coming for conversations, or like for hanging out. And this has been really, really nice. And also the process of getting to know each other and being there and showing presence and being a neighbor and understanding what it means to live there. Because I mean, a year is not very long. Now it's like a year and a half together with the time I spent in the other Knack house. But of course, I'm a very new neighbor, but it's still like I feel I've been very like welcome. And if I brought some ideas, like there was always like a kind of a conversation around them, and other ideas. And now,
That's cool. Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, well, my involvement, I live very close, like maybe 2 minutes away, but not in Willewaal. I guess my involvement is mainly through Knack. The first houses that were abandoned somewhere in 2007 were the first time that we got about 10 houses at once. At that time, maybe people felt that our presence in the area would kind of open up the end of the beginning, or the beginning of the end, I mean, sorry. And over time we had more than 25 houses, then 35, but then 10 had to be abandoned again because they were demolished, and then we had to kind of transfer the people from the south part to the north part. We have also have two guest apartments there for guest artists, so that kind of changes faster. And now I feel that because we occupy the empty houses, people are feeling more safe. And because they know us, my telephone number is mainly or sometimes on the windows, or at least they can connect, and we say hello and we introduce ourselves. And so now it becomes a more kind of related situation where people really are happy that artists live in the empty houses for as long as it lasts. But at least the houses are not empty or not being squatted, because there's a lot of squatting going on, but very different in the time than when we were squatting. Oh, it's not the same.
Definitely.
Not the same atmosphere. Mm-hmm. But I have been seeing it since 1991 changing, and it is the last emergency housing project. There were seven in a row in the south after the war, because it provided housing for people who lost their homes due to the bombardment. Wow. It was financed by the Swedish government to create this kind of emergency housing project. But this is the last one remaining. Not really the last one, but the last one in this kind of bungalow setting. But now it's really also the end.
So yeah.
And also, it was very good that NAC also occupied or made that these houses didn't close, because now we were counting with a neighbor the houses are only in the north part of the Billevall empty, and there's around 50 houses that are already closed down, and nobody knows how long that can be. It can be years, and that attracts a lot of problematic situations that we are also facing. So this is always quite interesting.
It's very unexpected a lot of times. I think I can
there's
imagine
a lot of things. There's this really nice looking neighborhood, very green, but there's also these closed down houses with these fake doors and fake windows. So and also all these neighbors who know they have to go at a point. And
I think it's hard to balance sometimes as well, the different aspects. It's really up and down. But I can imagine it. I do want to quickly ask about the program a little bit, because did you only curated it, or was it in together?
Well, it's not curated, so the only curation we were focusing on, it was that the content should be respectful, and also the content should be also conscious of the area it is, and also I found very important that it's no racist and no sexist, and also so respectful to each other. But for the rest, really what we put this call out after doing a survey. So we first did a survey on the area on Charlois, because this project is for artists in the area Charlois to have a connection to the Billevall. And so this call out, the people who got were the first on the list, and that's how it went after it. So there was, of course, conversations about what there was going to be exhibited and how that relates, or how that communicates with the neighborhood through the events or whatsoever. Mm-hmm. But for the rest, we did coordination, and then we did the coordination together. That's it.
That's super cool. So the artists were super free to do what they
There was no kind of profiling in advance. Mm-hmm. Because the reason was that people who needed income, that was the main reason.
Yeah.
And now also, because we're active now for almost a half year, we can also engage people from the neighborhood to make presentations, and that can be done in the future even more, but it takes time to involve people, and they become interested, maybe so they can also participate. So workshops was planned, but it's sometimes complicated. So there is still a lot of possibilities to do, which will also happen probably, because so by the end of December we made the 24th exhibition, but we already found some funding, and we're now preparing what we're going to do the coming year.
Yeah. Oh, that's exciting. That's super cool. But I think the growing space Willewaal.hatklu.me, M-E, that's also a place where some of the activities went to, or that people can still check out the greenhouse digitally.
Yeah,
I think so.
Yeah.
So I actually have one last question. I can imagine that with all the different exhibitions, a lot of them came in, a lot of unexpected elements came to play, or maybe an interesting conversation happened between neighbors or artists. Maybe one of you or both of you could share like a story maybe to close off the conversation.
Yeah, I have to think. But yeah, maybe, so many interesting
questions.
I mean, for example, right now the exhibition that is on is by Lily Ulrich and Nash Caldera. And it's interesting because they decided also to work with light, and right now it's like the so we've been building up separately from the greenhouse, but like just the neighbors together, all these Christmas or like winter lights around, and they also decided to work with light. So I think the conversations that are gonna happen is like, oh, you put these lights, or like, I put these lights, and this like the other way of. So like working with the same material but in different ways is going to be very interesting. But I have to say we couldn't have done this project also with the help of many, many neighbors that were so present since the beginning. So already I think one of the nicest stories that we had was in July when we finally got the permit after months of waiting. We started to build up the platform and everything. We did it ourselves with a team of six, seven other artists. Yeah. So for 3 days,
two days.
We rocked that. It was crazy, pretty nice.
But long days. But
yeah, it was long and really hot days. The neighbors were right in front of the street. They brought us so much food and coffee and tea and
flowers.
Like flowers, and that was so nice. And so yeah, it really like felt it makes sense to do this. And one of the neighbors is still super involved. He's happened to also be doing portraits, so he also had an exhibition. And so it's not just exhibition by artists, but also by neighbors who are also artists as well, but not a main occupation. And I thought that was very, like, that been very, for me, super nice and very warming.
Yeah, that's so nice. It's super beautiful.
Yeah, that's also the thing I'm thinking of. But that was also maybe the only time that we were really present for, two times almost, 16 hours a day. After that, of course, we are there sometimes, or at least once a week, but not that often. So then the contact is indirect. We have a post box where people can leave messages, or of course also via social media. But especially the first 2-3 days where you were busy, then if you're on site building, people can actually then also address you and talk to you, and then you can that was felt really good. People were so kind of excited as we are, and sometimes you think like there's a lot of demolishing, there's a lot of problems, and this was a really positive thing happening, and something being created instead of deconstructed, let's say.
Yeah.
And there's tension on all sides, but this is kind of not neutral, but it allows people to be kind of happy about regardless, because we don't represent anything, just ourselves, in fact.
I think that's a very important part of the project, that we are self-organized and we only come from cultural funding, and also part of the mostly cultural funding and NAC, and that for the neighbors has another quality. And it's very interesting because, of course, we're not, there, but we also, are outside sometimes, so we, meet them and have this conversation. I have, a lot of neighbors come into my house. They find out where I live, and then, they come with ideas or, So it's been, very nice, to put energy in this and, to try to, channel all that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's super cool. Yeah. Thank you so much for this conversation and sharing the stories with us. So thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.